Hello and welcome, everyone. This is your head derp, Eforen, and today I'm going to be doing a little bit of a tutorial on the Applied Energistics. Now, Applied Energistics just had a fairly sizable update fairly recently, and I was trying to learn it, and I couldn't really find any tutorials that I liked that were pretty short and succinct. So, here's my version of it. Okay, so first off, main thing you need to know. Meteorite compass. This thing is crucial for your stuff. So see how this is pointing in a direction? This is going to go off in this direction. And I actually happen to know that the meteorite is a little bit more off over in that direction. it's pointing a little bit off, but yes. So, when it's not sure where things are, it's going to spin slowly. When it's sure where it is and you are in the chunk that has a meteor in it, it's going to go ahead and spin. Now, it's not going to stop spinning until you mine out all of this. But the important thing to know is in the center here, you're going to have to go and mine this down, and somewhere in about the center of the meteor is going to be one of these skystone chests. Now, these have the Inscriber logic and Inscriber engineering in this particular one, but they can have any of those Inscriber ones. So that's the Inscriber. So any of these. So this calculation press, the engineering press, the logic press, the name press, and the silicon press. And you need at least the logic press, I think it is, and the silicon press to get started. So now let's get back to our demonstration hall over here, and I'll continue. So getting those can be kind of troublesome too, because if you do not look down underground, you might get a little bit confused, because they're not always on the surface. Sometimes they are underground, and so that can get confusing. Now, the other thing that's of particular note is that there is an interesting different mechanic now for crafting in here. You gotta go and throw these into water and see how they combine together. That made two Flux Crystals. That's how you make Flux Crystals now. And I don't think there's really any other way to make them. You don't make them into dust. Before you got dust and then you made the crystals from that, I believe. Now it's this way. If you do need dust for something, for example, the Annihilation Crystals, we still have the Quartz Grinder. And this is really simple. It's just a hand-operated grinder. You just go ahead and right-click this sucker. And there you go. You get some quartz dust. New thing here is the presses. So, for example, we put a logic press in there and a gold ingot. We go ahead and give that some power. And that's going to go ahead and burn through that power and make a printed logic circuit. Now, we're going to need this later. Because what we have to do is we have to make these silicon here. And this is just using that silicon press I told you about. Silicon. Boom. Then we go ahead here, and this is just going to power up, and boom, there's a printed silicon circuit. And we actually want two of them. That's why I left it on a little bit longer. Don't worry about how I'm supplying power to these things at the moment. I'm just using a creative energy cell. You can use, I think, anything that produces energy to do this. So now, to make the final circuit, before we could do other ways of making it, we could use printing from Buildcraft with the lasers. We could also do cooking it by hand and cutting the wafers. That doesn't work no more. What we got to do is we've got to put all these things in there. So we go in here, we've got these together, and we give it some power, and we're going to see that's going to combine them together. Now we can put all kinds of upgrades in here. We've got like speed upgrades, acceleration upgrades, all kinds of good jazz like that. So this here is another thing that's worth noting. Now this takes a while to do, so I'm not going to go and show you everything. But basically what you do is you have water, you combine the sand and the quartz dust, the quartz from the mod dust, not ender quartz, or nether quartz, sorry. And then you throw the seeds. Now, this is going to give you two seeds. You go and you throw the seed into water. And then it's going to go and it's going to sit there. Now, don't worry. Those aren't going to despawn or anything like that. But over time, they'll get some progress and they'll grow into a pure quartz crystal. So, that is very relevant to know later in the game. Because we definitely need some of those to make certain things. Now, the frame here, you can go ahead and most of the rest of this stuff is all pretty self-explanatory. If you have NEI, you're good. You know, don't worry about it after that. Just learn it through NEI. I'm not here to show you recipes. What I'm here to show you is how things are different and how to use the things. So we go down here. And this is the most basic setup you can have now. It's just a chest with an ME storage cell in it. And say, for example, we go here, take this stuff, we pop that in here, and boom, there we go. So now that's stored in there, and we can search by name. We could be like, you know, stone or cobble, and it's going to filter for us, just like NEI, but inside of a chest. Now, this will store as much as the cell can hold, and storage cell. You can see here, there's a bunch of different cells that can store different amounts of stuff. So, you can get pretty high amounts of stuff in here later. Now, a relevant thing. The top, you access the inventory. The side, you access the storage cell. Now, showing you how to make this, I'm pretty sure that it's pretty straightforward. You don't really need to know how to make this, but you can find the recipe. You just place down the chest, throw the storage in, put down your power supply, turn on your power supply, and there you go. You can access it. So now, if we take all this stuff out, we can go here, boom. All of this stuff goes in there, and there we go. Now you'll notice some flickering there. That's because it is pulling in the power into its internal buffer as we go. This would be more efficient if we had a power delivery system or a ME master controller. But we don't need the master controller anymore. So here we go. And for anyone who hasn't used ME before and doesn't know what these ME drives are about, you'll see if I switch the drives out, now, boom, different stuff is in there. If I go back to here, I switch the drives out again. Boom, now it's this stuff. So that's worth noting. Now, a little bit more of an advanced system. We have a power, or an energy acceptor, and we've got a small ME network here. Now, we can get a bit more advanced with this, with the basic non-controller networks. But this is a pretty basic, straightforward system. So, ME chest, it's got some stuff in it, same thing, that side. But now we can access it via this terminal as well. So we can pull stuff out of there. So for example, I pull the redstone out, and it's no longer here. Put it in here, and it's now over here. And see those lines? Those will become relevant later. I'll explain them pretty quickly. Now we go over here, and I'll show you how to build this. So, we go ahead and we slap down our power, and I'm going to slap our switch on there, our acceptor, and cabling, and then we'll put a terminal on there, and we'll put a chest. Now, one thing about these chests is you can now place them at, like, different angles, I believe. Yeah, so, see, I can place it so the front is accessible this way. But that's not what we want to do right now. Well, actually, let's do that. So we'll go ahead and place it like that. A little bit different. And this is more like the old terminals when it's like this. Except for it doesn't pull stuff out of the other ones. So now we could see that it was all gray, and we couldn't use anything. Well, it's still gray. Dark gray. So we couldn't access it. And if we get some blocks here, now we can go ahead and we can put those in. Except, wait, we can't put anything in there right now. So, why is that? Can't read storage cell. Oh, okay, we don't have our storage cell in there. So we go ahead, put that in. And now, see, it'll let us put stuff in there. And we can see that all that stuff is now showing up here. And again, if we switched them out, we'd have different inventory. One thing that's worth noting is that we can set up the access really far away, pretty much as far as we want, as long as it's loaded, I think. And it will go and withered away. Nice. It'll connect. It doesn't really matter how far it is, but it will take more power to do that. So the further away it is, the more power it's going to take up. Now, next thing here. When you're on these basic systems that don't have the controller in them, you only have 8 channels, is what it's called. So if you look here, we see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you've got 8 things on this channel here. Now, the relevant thing is, if we go and we hook up one more thing, boom, the network is dead. It doesn't have, it can't do anything anymore. Because we put too many things on there, it doesn't know what channel to assign things to. So if we remove this last one, now you can see it lights back up again, and we're good. Now, you could have less, and you see how it's not changing, right? It's not changing the cabling. That's because all of these are connected. When the chests are connected together, they network themselves automatically. So you see how that dropped it down? If we go here, then you can see we only have 2 of the brighter lights lit. If we went and we disconnected this one, then see how we only have 2 dim lights there. Go put that back and we have all of them. So that's something to keep in mind when using these smaller systems. You only have 8. So you say, oh, well, that's not much storage. Well, you can get a lot of storage in there because you can use these ME drives. Now, with this, I'm using quite a few channels. Only still within the 8, but I have a terminal, which is 1 channel, crafting terminal, which is another channel. Then we have an ME drive, which is a terminal, ME drive, ME drive, ME drive, ME drive, ME drive. And each one of these blocks is another channel. Now you ask, how can we have multiple of these in here? That's because the whole block is a channel, not each individual drive bay in the ME drive. So these are very useful for having lots of storage in a lower tier system when you're only having the non-controllered system. So that's pretty much all that I have for you in this tutorial, and that should get you up and running with basic ME systems pretty quickly. Now, I'm going to go ahead and make another tutorial with advanced ME systems using the controllers, and then I'm going to make some more tutorials using crafting, because the crafting system has changed a lot. It's no longer just one big ME block. Now remember, rate, comment, and subscribe. I'm not just saying that because I'm saying that and because I want attention, but that really helps these videos get to more people. So if you want to help more people out, let them see the video so that they can learn more about the ME system. Make sure you hit that like button and all those things so that we get more exposure. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a great day.